Hey, what's up, guys? This is Amber with Helps 2, and I'm here with Gabby.
Hello.
And today we're going to be talking to you about how to get started as a remote worker. And I'm going to go ahead and jump in and share with you guys my story of how I got started as a remote worker. I never imagined myself working remotely, working from home on my computer. I always worked just random jobs, you know, nannying, doing different things. But I always had a passion for creating things, creating graphics, creating beautiful images with photography, all these types of things. But I never imagined that I would be able to do that as a career or as a profession. And so I remember one day I was working with Gabby on a music team. We were together jamming out, you know, back in the day a few years ago. And I remember I was working three jobs just to try and stay afloat.
Which is crazy.
I was roughing it out
on the
street.
A lot of us creatives do that, I feel like.
Yeah, just to keep being able to do what I love, my art and my passion. I was working three jobs with kids mostly in childcare. And I was just venting. I was like, man, I'm just getting tired of this. I'm tired of burning myself out, running from job to job, you know, switching hats, switching roles all the time. I just want to like be creative, go full force all the time. And I just remember Gabby looks over at me and she goes, I'm looking for someone to do video for my company. And I was like, huh. And I thought, I don't have experience with that, but you know, she was willing to train me and bring me on to the team. And so that's actually how I got hired on with Helps 2. But since then, it's been quite a journey of learning how to go from working, you know, just other odd jobs that fueled my creative passion to actually working in a creative field and doing it remotely from home. And so, yeah, and I would say, like, one of the things that really got me to where I am, that got me to that place, was being open and being honest about like where I wanted to be.
Yeah.
The first thing I had to do was voice what I was thinking. I didn't expect, you know, a job offer to come out of that, but just to let a friend know, to let somebody know, like, hey, I want to be in a creative profession. I want a job that will allow me to work remotely, that will allow me to set my own hours, that will allow me all these things that I have now. And like, because I was open about that, like, that presented itself to me. And another thing that helped me to on this journey was bringing it back up, because, you know, it was something that Gabby kind of brought up as like, you know, let's talk about it down the road, maybe in a few months we can talk about, you know, bringing you on in the Helps 2 team. And I remembered that, and I'm not saying Gabby forgot. I don't know.
I didn't forget.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't forget what I say.
Sure.
I'm very particular. I will say, though, I love that point, just to, like, cut you off completely.
Sure. No,
I'm just kidding.
Okay.
Sorry. We have this kind of relationship. But honestly, the power of networking, I think a lot of us creatives are so afraid to be honest with our communities that we're already in about where we want to be. And we're like, we got to get somewhere on our own. And so when I got to hear your heart cry, Amber's heart cry of, hey, I don't want to be working three jobs. Like, I have this tremendous creative eye. That's why I put her on video. Like, you have to have a creative eye to do video. I personally, this is my belief, especially here at Helps Too, you have to have a creative eye, which is not something you just randomly wake up and have. It's like you have been trained, whether you know it or not, to see things in a very particular sense. And so she had that, and I knew that as a friend. And I was like, wow, I think now that you've voiced this true vulnerability, let's go for it. So yeah, it was really cool.
Yeah, yeah. And so, like, just being open in your community is really important to even get you to places you don't expect.
It's truly networking.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
That's exactly what networking is.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also being able to just bring it up again, because, you know, I put it back on the table a few months later. It was like, hey, you mentioned this. Like, is this still an option? And then we were able to discuss it again, and we were able to, you know, I was able to join Helps too. And
call follow through.
Yes,
follow through.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Be willing to speak up and follow through. And so, it's been an incredible journey. I love my job. I love working remotely. I love working with Helps too.
We being love able, her here too.
Being able to
Don't
work.
Don't tell her.
Oh my goodness.
I'm just kidding. She heard. Don't tell her.
Oh my goodness.
Anyways.
But yeah, I love being able to do something creative as a job. Like, it's incredible. And so.
It is cool. Hard work though. I think a lot of people that want to work remotely don't necessarily think it's going to be hard work. Mm-hmm. And so, and we've even had that conversation. Me and Amber have sat down and she's like, Gabby, yo, I love this job. I only love like the 60% of it. This other 40% I don't want to do.
That's
and
true.
I said, well, sounds like you're an adult. An adult, and just when you have a career in general, and it is something that's actually worth having, there's going to be just things you have to power through that you don't necessarily like to do per se, but they have to get done. And until you can find someone else to get them done, you have to do that. And so that's just part of working, mm-hmm. just in general. And working remotely is included in that. Now, if you're in a place where you're like, wow, that's really great. I'm glad Amber works for you, Gabby. That's awesome. You guys are wonderful, but that doesn't help me.
That's fair.
I'm here to give you some tips personally about how you could start working remotely and get onto that path right now. So I want to give you three quick tips. One is you can find and go search for jobs. There's a website called Indeed.com. If you go put in a type of job that you'd like to do that is remote, you can search for that job. So say you want to do digital marketing sales and you put the location as remote, you will get hundreds upon hundreds of jobs and they're updated daily. It is mm-hmm. wild. So many job opportunities that you can apply for. Another great way to go about that is a website called Upwork.com. It's used for just that, remote working. And then if you want to really kind of like start your own hustle and you're like, hey, well, maybe I don't want to work for someone else per se as a remote worker, but I want to start my own hustle or my own business, Fiverr.com. And that's spelled Fiverr.com. It's super awesome. You can get people coming to you because you offer a service. Well, I've seen people do collage videos. I've seen people do random animations, or some people are even transcribing things. There's so many options. You can look through the site, see what's available to you, and then say, whoa, I could actually do what this person is doing, and then offer a competitive rate and get on it. And honestly, some of you who are watching, you're creatives and you're like, well, I don't transcribe. Like, I'm a musician or I'm a designer. I have this philosophy, and I've preached it to Amber and everyone here at Helps Too. Hey, if you're creative, shoot to where your creativity and your creative pursuit can sustain you financially. Mm-hmm. But until then, get a job and let the job finance that creative journey and work yourself out of a job creatively. So even as a musician, before my music started making money, I was working in marketing, and I still love it, so I still work in marketing. But I love marketing music. That's just my life. But I was working in marketing, and it actually financed my music. It paid for my music videos. It paid for my tours. It paid for my albums. And now it's a blessing to see radio play happen, and I get $1,000 here or whatever. But like for so many years, for like 8-9 years, which is actually pretty average for a standard business to make a return. It takes 7 years on average mm-hmm. for a business to make a return. Mm-hmm. You know, that just wasn't happening for me. So I got a job and I financed my music. It didn't have to be one or the other. I did both. It was not easy, but it's what it takes. And so we want to encourage you guys, no matter where you're at in your creative journey, it's possible for you. Do you have anything else you want to say before we're done?
No.
That's it. Make sure you subscribe. And if you want to become a remote worker, drop a comment on this video and we want to just talk to you about it. Yeah. And if you are just like new here, make sure you make some friends in the comments as well. Until next time, we'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Peace out.